It's Easter Month at St. Helena's Church on Olmsted Avenue. This Sunday, this is an important one, a Know Your Rights workshop on immigration, very topical issue right now. Again, at St. Helena's, it's co-sponsored by my assembly member and Senators Klein and Senator Diaz. It starts at 1:30 after the Mass. Very topical issue, even if you're not in an immigration situation, it might be good to attend and learn something to help spread the word. And let's not forget, we have a spelling bee on March 11th. If you have middle grade children, contact your principal, get on his case, tell him to register for the spelling bee. Some good prizes, cash prizes, and college scholarships for it. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Covered all the representatives that are here. Did I miss anybody?
No.
Okay. Our assistant district attorney is going to give a report.
Just very quickly, the Bronx District Attorney's Office is offering a free informative workshop called After the Arrest. This kind of segues to what we were talking about before the criminal process. If you attend, the community will be able to learn more about the criminal court process. Specifically, what happens after someone's arrested, the process of going through central booking, you're being arraigned, and then how the case proceeds from there. If you're interested in attending, it's going to be at the DA's office on 161st Street, and it's scheduled for Wednesday, March 29th from 5:45 p.m. to 8 p.m. There are flyers in the back. I'm here if you have any questions. Again, my name is Jennifer.
And the VA special assistant is Rashawn, and Rashawn Horry. Rashawn, stand up, please, so they can see you. Call the neighborhoods if you have a problem. She's the person to contact. Okay, we're almost winding down. One last thing is that we're coming up to elections, which means that all positions are on the table, which means that you do have to be nominated, you do have to be in good standing in order to be part of that process. But that process entails, first of all, nominating, second, and actually running for a position, but you do have to have, and you do have to be in good standing. Next month, if you've only got two meetings under your belt, then next month you have to attend that meeting to have three meetings. So,
I thought it was 6 weeks.
Tina, you don't have to worry. You made them all. So that's about all. Next month I'll also pick a nominating committee. And that'll be three people who will look at the records and find out who's eligible. That'll be posted. And then we go through the nominating process. And then we have elections in June. So, that being said, I'll also have a notice of these different offices later on. And I just wanted to let everybody know that we're starting in a different direction. There will be different people in charge of different events. So, for instance, Sylvia Mazzella will be chair of the breakfast, the fellowship breakfast committee. Okay. Let me get my list. So, each one of the board members is going to really have to work for their pay.
Well, you get nothing, so you do nothing.
So Sylvia Mazzella has is chairperson of the breakfast committee. The Columbus Day Parade, the chairperson is Kate Carolina, and she's working in partnership with Brian Adams. National Night Out, chairperson is Hazel Mira.
Who's Hazel?
Everybody, of course, is involved in that. The Kalesi Run is Andrea Siegel. And the holiday food drive will be Stephanie Baptist. So we send out our literature. Their names will be on those letters, along with community affairs as contact people. This way, I can concentrate more on fundraising, which we fell a little short last year. So it's very, very important that we get our funds in. That's one thing, and also for different activities that I can start. So, and of course, when these suggestions are made, when they'll be brought back to the entire board, and the entire board will vote on. You know, we're going to have a problem with National Night Out this year because we can't use a regular place on Pelham Parkway. They're not allowing us, the Parks Department is not allowing us to be there. So we have to look for a new location. And of course, we have to raise funds and things. For everything we do, we have to raise funds. So, but we are starting a new direction. Everybody has a responsibility. We all work with the police department. So our partners in all of these things are community affairs, because we support the police. That's our major job, is to support the police and the programs. And the police will, and the community affairs officers will be in touch with us in just about every step of the way. But I don't see any slacking off. Last year, we still had about 3,500 people that came to our National Night Out. We're one of the biggest, if not the biggest, in Bronx. Our food drive, we collected 15,000 pounds of food.
Wow.
We had teachers, we had schools, the Cub Scouts involved. So I don't see anything that's going to bring that down. If nothing else, hopefully these committees and having the time and the space to go out and canvas, we will bring in even more food and have more successful programs. So that's the idea. Now, these chair people are chair people. But they're going to call upon, especially some of our long-term and trusted members of the group, to help out in these things. So let's say, for instance, if Kate calls you and say, "Look, Bob, I need a little help. I need something that you know about that you can do." And so she's empowered to do that. So we are going to utilize a lot of the people that want to volunteer in these various committees. Mm-hmm. So, that being said, now we're going to have a drawing for this.
Did you do the gallery? Hmm? Gallery?
Gallery.
Oh, the gallery. Right. Yeah.
We only have three people actually
all right,
in
so
the gallery.
The heck with them.
Kenny Augusto, you already spoke with us. Okay, so you're fine.
The Parks Department said last year that they would
you already spoke.
Right.
That's
what they said.
Fine.
Yeah. We're not even finishing.
And Janka, you spoke.
Mm-hmm.
And spoke.
I already spoke.
And spoke again.
And then spoke. So now we're going to have a drawing. Yes.
Maybe one more question. Please, with all your events, Pamela Damon has a women's etiquette group called Talit Yakumi. Please reach out to them, because those girls are eager to get involved in any and all activities. So if you need volunteers, sure. Also, I think Varon, who's also a member of the council, they left flyers for an upcoming event on human sex trafficking that they're having as well.
That's true. That is very important. There's more people than just us, people in this room, that have programs and exciting programs and programs that help. The one that that Jean just mentioned is very, very important, because it deals with trafficking of young women and putting them into the prostitution rings and taking advantage of them. So please take a flyer when you leave on that, because that is super important. That's what's going on. Now we can have our door.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Wait, wait, she's still selling tickets.
Oh, she's still selling tickets. Wait a second. We use these dollars. Most of you got postcards. So we use these dollars.
Send it to my mother's house. You know that? They still send it to my mother's house and I don't remember.
No, I don't get, I've never gotten a postcard.
We have it on the computer. Still but we also send out postcards for those people that don't look at their computer, don't have a computer, or just forget. No, you can talk to us after we close up. No, you're not here to talk to the public. You're here to talk to us. I'll tell you what, next time you come, next meeting you come, bring in literature on what you have. And then when you're speaking,
whatever you're ready.
And as long as it's pretty, you can sort of tell me. Now, everybody should have a first aid kit. Let me just mention that. Everybody should have a first aid kit.
Yes.
Especially if you have children, grandchildren, keep it in the house. We all get burned, we all get cuts, we all fall down, scrape our knees. So it's very important.
Something bigger than that.
Have a good first aid kit.
What do you say?
That's where you're coming from.
A second aid kit. Although the Red Cross used to give out, they used to have these the nice plastic cases with the scissors and the gauze and everything in there. Now, what do you get? Nothing.
They don't do that anymore.
You get two band-aids and a wish and a good luck wish.